Tune into this Xamarin Essential API of the Week, where I show you how to send an email from your iOS, Android, or Windows device with a single line of code. Welcome back, everyone, to another Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Today, we're going to take a look at email, which is a super simple API enabling you to send an email in the default email client on your iOS, Android, or Windows device. What's really nice is you can do all of this with a single line of code, send to multiple recipients, send the body or the subject, and even add attachments. So let's take a look at how to get started. Here I am inside of my App Essentials that I use in all my demos, and I've installed Xamarin Essentials into all of my projects. And that's super important when you want to get started to ensure that you have everything that you need for iOS, Android, Windows, and in your .NET Standard project. Now, of course, we're going to need to go into our Android project and make sure we have the Xamarin Essentials API set up. If you need more information on getting started, I'll put links in the show notes below. But let's take a look at how we can send an email. I've set up a very, very simple email sheet where I ask for the email address and the subject, and then I have a button to submit or to send that email. So let's go into the code behind and see how to implement this. Over here on the button tab, we can come in and start using Xamarin Essentials. So here we can go Xamarin.Essentials. And we'll get all of the different APIs that are available. The one that we're going to look for today, you guessed it, is email. So here you can simplify this by just saying email dot. And this is going to give us a single method that we can call with a few overloads to send an email. So let's take a look at how to compose an email. Here we can just simply open the default client with nothing attached. It won't have any information at all, any subject. We'll just open it up. Or we can pass in an email message, which we'll take a look at. Or we can simply set the subject, body, and a parameter of strings for to, or who you want to send this email to. So here what we'll do is we'll say entry subject.text. No body for this one, but you could fill in the body. And then for the string arguments, this is just any amount of strings that you want to pass in for the email. So we'll say entry email.text, since we just have a single one, and we'll say OK. Now we'll see this is asynchronous, so this is just going to ensure that it opens. There's no callback when it finishes, it's just that it opened up. So we're going to mark this with a wait here to make sure everything is properly set up. And we've marked our method with an async, so the await is good to go. So now all we need to do with that single line of code is hit debug on our iOS, Android, or Windows device, and we should get the subject that we've specified and the email address as well. So since I have email set up on my physical phone, I'm going to be screen mirroring it here with Visor. And let's go into that email section right here. I'll set the email address. We'll say Jamont at Microsoft.com. And then for the subject, I'll say hello from Essentials. And we'll say submit. And now this is going to launch Gmail right here with the subject and my to email in place. That's it. A single line of code, Xamarin Essentials handles it all for you. But let's take a look at what else we could do. Here, instead of just passing in the entry, we could also say message and create a new email message. Now, an email message can optionally take in those same exact parameters here. So let's go ahead and pass those in. Here we can pass in the subject, body, and to. So it's actually the same exact parameters. And we can pass in the message. What's nice here, though, is that there's some additional properties on message. So let's zoom in here. What we can see is that we can not only just send the to, but we can add BCCs, specify body formats, the CCs, and even add file attachments. So these are any files that you have on disk, which you could write with system.io, for instance. Additionally, you can always set the to arguments or the subject there too. And this will just take in a list of strings. Now, that body format is actually pretty important. Here, you can specify if it's HTML or plain text. But remember that some of these are only supported on certain operating systems. So we default to plain text because it's supported everywhere. But if you need to spice it up on iOS or Android, you can mark that as HTML and actually pass in HTML to your email client. And that's it. That's how you're able to construct an email message, pass it to Compose, and even add attachments. Be sure to read the documentation on how to specify everything, but that's it. With a single line of code, we're sending emails from our application. Hope that you enjoyed this Xamarin Essential API of the Week, and check out all the Xamarin Essentials APIs of the Week here on Channel 9 and on YouTube. So until next time, I'm James Montemagno, and thanks for watching. Hey, it's James. I'm just checking in and wanted to thank you for watching this awesome Xamarin Essential API of the Week. Now, don't forget to do all the things, such as like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell for even more videos. And while you're here, check out more Xamarin Essential API videos of the week. They're all right here. Go do it right now. It's awesome.